Walt Disney World Resort in beautiful, sunny Florida. It's the 1991 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. With two fabulous parades from the Disney MGM Studios, catch all the magic and excitement of Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Parade. And from the Magic Kingdom, it's Disney's colossal all-new 20th Anniversary Surprise Celebration Parade. Join your co-host for this Christmas Day extravaganza, Joan Lunden and Regis Philbin, along with Blossom's Mayim Bialik, for the world's biggest, most spectacular Christmas parade, celebrating 20 years of Walt Disney World magic. Kick up your heels with dancing reindeer in a sparkling Christmas spectacular. Come face to face with Beauty and the Beast at the Disney MGM Studio. Celebrate a worldwide Disney Christmas in California and France. Thrill to Disney's dazzling new light spectacular, Spectro Magic. Come along with the Disney girls for some fun in the Florida sun. Say hello to Lee Greenwood and Sandi Patti. Plus, see dinosaurs, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, The Little Mermaid, Mickey, Minnie, and the whole Disney gang.
London, and welcome to the 9th annual Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
And I'm Regis Philbin. Merry Christmas, everybody. Have we got a great show for you. Disney's biggest Christmas celebration in history. Two spectacular parades in two great Disney theme parks.
Hi, I'm Mayim Bialik. Happy holidays, everyone. This is my first Christmas here at Walt Disney World, and I am so excited. I can't wait for the parade to begin. Well, all the Disney Christmas fun is right around the corner, so stay where you are because we'll be right back.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Johnson & Johnson, where quality products for the American family have been a tradition for generations. Kissimmee, St. Cloud, Florida, the vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction. And AT&T, proud to sponsor our Olympic hopefuls as they train for the 1992 U.S. Olympic team.
And welcome back to the Very Merry Christmas Parade. We're coming to you live from Walt Disney World in Florida. And sitting next to me this year in his first appearance as co-host is Regis Philbin. And Merry Christmas.
Well, Merry Christmas to you, Joan. Thanks very much. It's a thrill for me to be here with you today. You know, the first thing that caught my eye was the fact that really is the Magic Castle.
People think it's a painting.
I thought it was a painting all these years.
No, it's real.
A little scrim in front of it, but gee, it's terrific to be here with you.
Well, it's great to have you here. We have a lot of Christmas excitement at Walt Disney World this year. Two parades. Beauty and the Beast.
Oh, thank you. Why do you point to me when you say Beast? How do you like this? And Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, dinosaurs, we've got everything. And let's get things started now by going over to the Disney MGM Studios with Mayim Bialik.
Thanks, Regis and Joan. It's a fantastic day here at the Disney MGM Studios. This is really the place to see the stars. And in a couple seconds, lots of your favorite Disney characters are going to come parading down Hollywood Boulevard for the very first time in history. This is like a big, glamorous Hollywood premiere. I mean, can you stand the anticipation? Is this going to be a great parade or what? Yeah! Sir, what do you think of the studio?
Oh, the studio is great.
You having a good time?
Having a great time.
Everybody having a nice Christmas?
Yes.
Good. It's going to get even better because the time for the parade has come. Everybody ready? Gentlemen, boys and girls, Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Parade. All right, thanks, Mayim. And what better way to start off Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Parade than with a marching band?
Absolutely, Joan. They are the Lake Mary Marching Band under the direction of Terry Padishaw from right here in Central Florida. Now, I think you know how long these kids have been working. for this appearance.
All year round.
All year long.
Yeah, these 150 musicians have participated in the Walt Disney World 20th anniversary ceremonies here at the Disney MGM Studios.
And they were in the world's largest concert at EPCOT Center for the Music Educators National Conference.
Ah, look at that little one. They line the streets here from very, very early in the morning to get a good seat. And this is just the thing to really kind of set the mood for a big parade, so let's listen a moment.
All right, here it comes, everybody. Here come the Disney classics coming to life there on Hollywood Boulevard.
Those are the knights, the fearless knights, mm-hmm. if you will, who protect Sleeping Beauty's court.
You know, that sounds like a terrific job. A guy like me could help them protect Sleeping Beauty.
I don't know.
How do you get a job like that? What do you think?
Well, I would imagine that there'd be a lot of training, wouldn't there?
You know what, Joan? I guess you'd have to go to night school.
Oh, Reed.
All right, Princess Aurora.
Hey, look who's there. Well, Princess Aurora is better known, of course, as Sleeping Beauty.
Yes.
She's from Walt Disney's 1959 classic.
Mm-hmm.
And she's there with her Prince Philip.
Prince Philip, yes, absolutely. I'll never forget that terrific scene when Prince Philip fought the fire-breathing dragon. Remember that?
Yeah, and he won,
And too. He won, too. Pretty hot stuff.
Yes, and he awakened Sleeping Beauty with that one kiss,
What a kiss, Joan. After all, Aurora slept through a pretty noisy battle. You talk about a heavy sleeper.
And here we've got another marching band with Major Mike leading the way, right?
You
He's your favorite.
I love Major Mike. I really do. He's been a fixture here at Disney for so many years. He's always up. He's always happy.
Well, this
always
is the band's
smiling.
20th anniversary. We've got a lot of anniversaries today. It's
sure
their
do.
20th anniversary. And here at the studios, they're performing the role today of Royal Band to herald the arrival of Cinderella. And Mike Davis is also celebrating an anniversary. It's his 10th year of directing the band and managing the musicians.
Remember that movie, The Music Man?
Yeah.
This guy is a real-life music man.
Yeah, he really is. Look at him there.
And the crowd loves him, too. You know, one time I saw him walking around like that, he didn't even have a band behind him. He was just walking around smiling. Major Mike. There he is again. I love Major Mike.
I think the crowd loves him, too.
Yeah, they do. They wait for him every year. And he waits for them. He enjoys it.
Look at all the people with the Santa hats. That's great. All right, now this is a beautiful sight on Hollywood Boulevard. These are the dancers from the court of Cinderella and Prince Charming, leading the way for the stars of Walt Disney's 1950 animated classic.
Mm. You know, Joan, I have a confession. Of all the Disney ladies, the one that I had the biggest crush on ever since I was a kid was Cinderella.
Now, did you think we didn't know that? The way you act down there on the
Remember?
Street for the last 8 years, you've been flirting
and
with
did
Cinderella.
Did you notice the way she looked at me, too? She always seemed like the girl next door to me, even though I never had anybody like her living next door to me.
Well, she's a very likable person, and Cinderella is really one of Disney's most popular films ever.
That's right, yep. And I even love the magic coat she rides around in, too. Even though she's become a princess, she still hasn't let it go to her head. Still a very charming lady.
Look at that. I always love the little white ponies. They are so tiny that pull Cinderella.
Mm-hmm.
There she is.
Hi, Cinderella. It's me, Regis.
And there's Prince Charming.
Oh, the old prince looking better than ever.
Cinderella's fairy godmother and Cinderella's mice. Friends. Those are Susie and Pearlie, you know.
Now, how do you know their names? Because nobody ever calls them Susie and Pearlie except you.
Well, they told me personally, Regis.
What a great parade, and this is just the beginning, everybody. There's a lot more to come now on this magical, and I mean very magical, Christmas morning.
Right, Regis, and there's Christmas magic in the air all over Walt Disney World, and there's music in the air. So let's join the voices of liberty at the Magic Kingdom at really the most wonderful time of the year.
Wonderful time of the year.
With the kids jingle belling,
with everyone telling you be of good cheer.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
rides with friends, lunch and cross country call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago.
Coming up next, Disney's colossal new 20th anniversary surprise celebration parade. So don't go away.
All right, welcome back, everyone, to the very Merry Christmas Parade coming to you live from Walt Disney World in Florida. Lots of magic coming your way, including the Disney stars of Beauty and the Beast.
But right now, let's kick off the second of our two big parades. And this parade, I mean, is really big. I'm talking gigantic. I'm talking colossal!
It's the new surprise celebration parade at the Magic Kingdom celebrating Walt Disney World's 20th anniversary.
And it's got just about everything, Joan. Parties from all over the world, Disney characters towering up to 40 feet. I just can't wait to see it, Joan.
All right, well, here we have it going underway right now down on Main Street, USA. A surprise celebration.
Dixieland beat going on there, huh?
And I see Pinocchio down there.
Pinocchio, where is he?
He's all decked out for a little Mardi Gras celebration.
Oh, yeah, sure.
He was a little wooden puppet who, of course, came to life when his father, Geppetto, wished upon a star.
Now, where's Jiminy Cricket?
He see, I saw him dance by a minute ago.
Oh, yeah, with the umbrella and the sash, I'll bet.
Which fits right in, of course, to Mardi Gras tradition.
Sure. Jiminy's usually the leader of the band. You know, Pinocchio had better be careful. That sly fox, Honest John, is usually around and usually up to no good.
Now, just behind him is going to come our first inflatable, 40 feet high, our big guy. He loves a girl named Jessica. Who could it be?
Oh, but it's got to be the one and only
Roger Rabbit.
Yes. Roger, bigger than ever. He's at the heights of stardom here. Look at the size of him. Did I tell you it was going to be spectacular, folks? I mean, I'm looking at... wait a minute.
I know those girls.
Oh, come on. Not again. How many years in a row can they be selected by random?
My little Jamie, Lindsay, and Sarah.
Please. And they're getting bigger every year.
The first parade I did here 9 years ago, I only had Jamie. And now I've got three of them.
Well, what a thrill for them to be on Roger's inflatable float there.
And you can see the real Roger Rabbit up there on the front, clowning around, because he is a crazy, crazy, zany guy. Look at the fans! Oh, look at them with the little Roger Rabbits on the hat!
Roger's got his own groupies!
Now, way up on the top of this inflatable is a camera.
Mm-hmm.
Now, where are we looking? Oh, look at that! That's his nose!
You're looking straight down,
and you're seeing people along the street.
This is what Roger is seeing, as a matter of fact.
That could give you a nosebleed way up there.
This is Roger Cam.
Okay, here are your favorites.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look, there's the blimp shot. We should talk about that a bit because the blimp is coming today from Aerial Adventures Lightship. It's being piloted by Captain Jim Dexter.
Mm-hmm.
And the blimp provides sightseeing rides for up to four passengers and provides beautiful panoramic views of Orlando. Great shot for us.
Yeah. Now, here's something different. You know stilt walkers?
I don't know.
We've got some stilt dancers. And it took these Disney performers just a month to capture this, and they're really terrific at it. I mean, that's a lot of them.
Yeah, there are a lot of them in the parade today that you're going to see, and it's amazing what they can do.
Mm-hmm. Still going at it. How did that guy make the turn like that? You know,
I don't know how
they
do it.
A lot of practice.
And you'll see the costumes today are truly unbelievable.
Traditional Mardi Gras colors.
They've kind of stolen from carnivals all over the world, Rio, New Orleans.
You know, what is this? Is this Main Street USA or the road to Rio?
These are the Carmen Banana dancers, huh?
I love those.
You like those?
I love that headdress.
A little fresh produce there, huh? Mm-hmm.
Makes me want to, gives me a yen for fresh produce. It really is a carnival atmosphere out there. It's just kind of nice, isn't it?
Yes, it's very different.
As we head into Mardi Gras season. Crowd having a great time as always.
And the weather down here has been so spectacular.
What a day we've got. What a day. Blue skies, 70 degrees.
Now we're getting ready right now.
Is it time, Joan, to meet another big Disney superstar or not?
Mickey Mouse's sweetheart. They both appeared in the very first animated film with sound, Steamboat Willie, and there she is, all decked out in her carnival outfit.
It's Minnie Miranda.
Oh, Minnie Mouse. Taller than ever, huh?
And just as young and pretty, too. One thing about Minnie, she never ages, does she?
No, but she gets a lot taller.
She sure does. Look at the size of that thing. It's fabulous. Taller than
you
ever.
You can see now as it comes down Main Street the size of it in relation to the buildings.
Yeah.
Look at that shot from the blimp.
Oh, my
These things are so enormous.
Mm-hmm.
And they're cold air inflatables.
Up to 40 feet high. She's become a celebrity in her own right. She, for a little while there, was under Mickey's shadow, but the last 30 years, she's on her own.
Now, she's pretty amazing, but so are all the stage shows here at Disney World. And right now, let's go over to Cinderella's Castle for a sparkling Christmas spectacular.
Aunt Bradley, Aunt Bryant.
Aunt Bentley, Aunt Brewster.
Aunt Brewster.
Aunt Brewster.
Thank you.
Bruce Adams, and this is my son Christopher, Lucas, and my wife Denise. We're from Spokane, Washington, and we want to wish you all a Merry Christmas.
It's a Caribbean Christmas with the Little Mermaid. Plus, Disney's dazzling nighttime spectacular, Spectro Magic, when we come back.
Are we under contract?
Good tidings we bring
to you and your kin.
Good tidings for Christmas and a happy new year.
Well, that was only practice.
Now bring us a figgy pudding.
Now bring us a figgy pudding.
What is figgy pudding?
Now bring us a figgy pudding.
Now bring some out there.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. Wish you a Merry Christmas.
That's a take.
What great sports they are. Those are guests here at Walt Disney World. They're pretty good.
Not bad, but I don't think they should quit their daytime jobs right now.
But they are good sports. Welcome back, everyone, to the Walt Disney World Parade in Florida. We are live.
Yes, and Christmas cheer is everywhere. In fact, later on, we'll be going to Disneyland in California for a very special performance of Mickey's Nutcracker.
But right now, let's go over to the Disney MGM Studios for more Christmas parade fun. All right, coming down Hollywood Boulevard there, stars of Walt Disney's very first feature-length animated film.
Who was that? Snow White, of course, and the Seven Dwarfs. And the prince.
There's Snow White and her prince right there.
All of these ladies have a good-looking prince around them.
That's right.
50 years ago that all started.
What a work of art.
Mm-hmm. She really is. Can you believe the evil queen was ticked off at her for being so beautiful? I mean, how can you get mad at Snow White? What's the matter with that silly witch? Gotta love little Snow White.
Ah, look at the children. Snow White is a favorite with all the children.
Yeah, the kids love her. And you know who else they love? Those seven little dwarfs.
And there they are to celebrate Christmas with Snow White.
Do I see Frosty hanging around there, too?
He's down there.
Yeah, he's been a celebrity in his own right, you know.
Now let's see if we can remember, though, their names.
Oh, come on.
We go through the...
Grumpy, Dopey, Sneezy, Happy.
Doc.
Dashful. The last one.
Doc, Dopey, Grumpy, Happy, Sleazy,
Chico, I think it was.
Oh, no, there's Frosty.
Oh, he's melted. Up, Frosty, up.
He's made a special Christmas snow.
He sure is.
You know, when Walt Disney was picking out the voices, he had the actors stand in another room. He didn't want to be influenced by how they really looked in real life.
No kidding.
As he was picking out these voices.
That's the way to do it, too. All those little voices for those little people.
It's Little Mermaid Ariel.
And another prince.
That's right, Prince Eric.
How many princes do we have to have around here?
He went through so much to get a date with Prince Eric.
Now, I've seen just about, there she is again. Beauty, isn't she?
This is a favorite of my little girl. She's 16 years old, and she's the youngest of seven daughters.
Yes, all the kids are watching that tape. Now, am I seeing fishes on roller skates?
That's true.
You never know what you're going to see around this
Anything
place.
Can happen at Disney MGM Studios.
Well, everybody's sure going to love the incredible new Voyage of the Little Mermaid attraction, which is coming out in January to the Disney MGM Studios.
That'll be great.
Great addition. It's going to be.
Under the sea celebration here.
Wow.
Now, everybody's enjoying the Christmas movie magic at the Disney MGM Studios. Let's join Blossom's Mayim Bialik for some on-the-spot coverage of all the excitement.
Joan and Regis, we're having a great time here on Hollywood Boulevard. The parade is really great, right, guys?
Yeah!
You know, I've been talking to a lot of these people, and we have people here from all over the place. Some natives from Orlando, Long Island. Yeah, I've been practicing. Chicago, Connecticut, another Chicago, Sarasota. Lots of Long Island, lots of Ohio, and Atlanta. We got a lot more parade coming your way. But first, you're in for a very extra special treat: the television debut of Disney's new nighttime parade spectacular, Spectro Magic. And here is Regis to tell you more about it.
It took over 30,000 man hours to create Disney's newest nighttime spectacular. First, Disney costumers went to work creating the most magnificent costumes. Next, choreographers spent months in rehearsals with dancers as they perfected their routines. Musicians gathered to record all new music using classic tunes from favorite Disney films to have just the right sound for Spectro Magic. Each evening backstage in the Magic Kingdom, Disney cast members get set for another illuminating performance. At last, the moment everyone's been waiting for. 5, 4, 3, 2, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Spectro Magic!
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. From Patti LaBelle and Walt Disney World. See ya.
Stay where you are. Next up, a Christmas visit to Disneyland in California.
Welcome back to the Very Merry Christmas Parade.
And take a look at that blimp shot. We're coming to you live from Walt Disney World in Florida on a beautiful sun-drenched Christmas morning.
Merry Christmas to everyone watching here in the USA, but also in Europe, Australia, the Far East, Canada, South America, and of course all the servicemen and women all
Sounds
over the
like
world.
Sounds like the whole world to me. We've got a lot of show coming your way, including the television premiere of the new Beauty and the Beast stage show that's knocking people out down here. We're talking about a magnificent Broadway-style show, folks, coming up soon.
But right now, let's go to Main Street, USA for more of Disney's 20th anniversary surprise celebration parade. And here they are coming down Main Street. Looks like a pineapple to me.
Yeah, first there was the pumpkin coach, and now the pineapple coach.
And down there we've got Baloo and Louie.
Love those guys, and their friends seem to love them too. You probably remember those guys from Disney's classic movie, The Jungle Book.
That's right, or from Disney's hit TV adventure, Tailspin.
Looking at the coach, suddenly I have another craving.
I know, more pineapples, more produce. Hey, there are our samba dancers, Regis.
Yes. Mardi Gras continues here.
The color down on Main Street today is pretty unbelievable. It'll wake you up.
Really something, isn't it? Look at that headdress there, coming right out of her shoulders. 70 degrees here, can't beat it. Well, Joan, I'm getting ready, you know, for another gigantic Disney superstar. I just feel it. Oh, I love, look, still
More
dancers
still
are everywhere.
But look at these still dancers.
Yeah.
Look at the costumes they have on. How they do that, I don't know. These guys are so tall, they're almost as tall as our inflatables. If you're just tuning in, there's a new portion of the parade this morning that are these giant
Give me a hint. Who's it going to be,
Joan?
Who's it going to be? Tell me.
Well, he's a fowl.
Yes.
An irrepressible fowl. He has a girlfriend named Daisy.
Daisy? That means it's got to be the one, the only Donald Duck.
There he is. He began his career in 1934 in the movie The Wise Little Hen.
Nobody gonna tangle with a duck that size. It's the biggest duck in the whole world.
And been making the world laugh for almost 60 years. Look at that shot. Now, I guess that's from the blimp up high. And you can see how these things literally tower over all the buildings.
Exactly. You can look right on the roofs there. I think people like it because he's so human, Joan. You know, he's not perfect. His life is not perfect. And just like me, sometimes he gets out of control.
He does have a temper. Ah, there you got the three caballeros. A great film.
Mm-hmm. Jose Carioca. Or is it Jose Carioca? Hey, there they are.
Don Bam. They've all got beaks on their heads.
Do you like the rhythm?
I love that mouth.
Yeah, the three caballeros down there, you said one was Jose, and there's also Panchito, remember?
Yeah.
And they're all decked out in their carnival costumes.
Now, what would you say if you saw a plane flying too close to that?
I don't know.
You'd say, hey, Donald, duck! Got it, Joan? Did you get it?
I got it. I got it. It's so much fun doing the green cheer.
Can't get over the size of this parade. You know, Joan, I always thought Donald Duck was a big windbag, and I guess that kind of proves it.
You better not let him hear you say that. He really does have a very bad temper.
Probably blow up, you know? But we're having such a great time, even Donald can't get mad today. There's a big celebration everywhere you look.
And wait until you see this. Let's go down to Disneyland right now. That's out in California, where the Disney theme park magic began over 35 years ago. Here's a look at their unique version of the Nutcracker.
Sing like we ought to. Everybody's got a sweet, sweet smile.
Everybody bounce.
And Sandy Patti salute the points of light.
All right, welcome back, everyone, to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. They really are magic, aren't they? Welcome back to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, coming to you live from Walt Disney World in Florida.
We've got a lot more fun coming your way, including a very special appearance by Beauty and the Beast in their new stage show at the Disney MGM Studios.
And I can't wait to see that. Yeah. What a wonderful Christmas this is, and I think the holidays are a favorite time of year because it's a time that you have with family and with friends. It's a time, of course, to count our blessings. It's also a time to reach out a helping hand to others who may not be as fortunate as the rest of us. And right now, I'd like to tell you about a very, very special youngster. He lends a helping hand to others in need all year long. His name is Scooter Cantrell. He's only 13 years old. And Scooter has been working with our Special Olympians for over 4 years now. And through his volunteer efforts, he shows us how we too can bring joy and happiness to someone else's life. And Scooter has been designated the point of light for today, Christmas Day, by President Bush, because through his volunteer efforts, he lights up each and every life he touches. In fact, we are honored to have Scooter and his family with us today, and right now, let's join him and Mayim Bialik at the Disney MGM Studios.
Thank you, Joan. I'm here with the Cantrell family and, of course, Scooter, who, as Joan just said, was named a point of light by President Bush on Christmas. Congratulations, Scooter.
Thank you. It's a great honor to me, especially for doing something that I love doing.
Now tell me, what exactly was it that made you want to do this?
Well, at first, my mom's a Special Olympics coach, and I thought I just loved it, so I went and got certified as a coach and been doing it ever since.
Now, do you have any advice that you could give to any teenagers or really anyone who would be interested in getting involved?
Just to tell them to go out and volunteer, and it's very rewarding, and you'll have a great time.
That's great. Thank you, and Merry Christmas to you and your family.
Merry Christmas.
Scooter is just one point of light. Over 600 have already been named by President Bush. In fact, during Walt Disney World's 20th anniversary, President and Mrs. Bush were here with Lee Greenwood and Sandi Patti to honor the points of light. Let's join them at EPCOT Center.
Everything here at EPCOT reminds us of the vision of the man who conceived this amazing place as an exploration of community. Walt Disney once said, "The greatest moments in life are not concerned with selfish achievements, but rather with the things we do for the people." And he was absolutely right. And that creed brings us together in this extraordinary place, sharing this extraordinary day. We celebrate the American spirit, the greatest natural resource of this, the greatest nation in the entire world.
We can build a new tomorrow, starting today. And a point of light will be our guide.
Each of us can be a candle, lighting the way with a flame that burns from deep inside.
Like a beacon to a ship on a stormy night, points of light will guide our way. Each point of light gives a ray of hope to another. Each point of light is a gift of love from your heart.
America stands united with hope.
Stand united.
It's America's hottest new couple, Beauty and the Beast, when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
Bambi and Thumper.
Little Thumper.
Welcome back, everyone, to Walt Disney World in Florida for more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Yes, we're coming to you live from the Magic Kingdom, and this has got to be the biggest parade spectacular in all of Walt Disney World's 20-year history. This show has it all. Later on, you'll even meet the beautiful Disney girls on a very special tour of Walt Disney World.
And don't forget, I love to even say their name, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. They are on their way. Coming down Hollywood Boulevard.
Yeah, here's a crazy thing. What do we have? A hay wagon rolling down Hollywood Boulevard. I mean, you never know what to expect around here.
That's right, a little dancing scarecrow there for you. I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
Well, you're beginning to sound like Dorothy, Joan. You can visit the Land of Oz, incidentally, here at the Disney MGM Studios on the Great Movie Ride, which I've been on many times in the Chinese Theater.
Bye. Now along for the hayride up there are Brer Rabbit, Brer Fox, and Brer Bear, celebrating the 45th anniversary of Disney's Song of the South, and of course the opening of Splash Mountain. They're opening Splash Mountain here at Magic Kingdom next fall.
I can't wait for Splash Mountain. It's a 45-degree waterfall where you'll plunge at almost 40 miles an hour.
Sounds like fun to me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I recognize that music, Toyland back there.
Santa's Toy Factory.
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Santa Claus visit Walt Disney World, and they not only bring elves, but they bring the Toy Factory and Raggedy Ann and Andy there, you can see.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that's Gadget up there in the purple.
Yep.
The resident genius of TV's Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers, right, overseeing the whole Toy Factory.
Glad they're here.
And she is really high up there. And just to her left there, you see Scrooge McDuck.
I love Scrooge McDuck, you know. He's still searching for treasure all over the world.
From DuckTales.
Turtles.
And look at the big elephant there, that big guy. Yeah, Colonel Hattie from Jungle Book.
All these great characters. It's quite a show for the people on the street.
I think I just saw the monkeys down there also from the Jungle Book.
Mm-hmm. King Louis Court.
And his little nephews there, Donald's little nephews.
Now, they were my favorite. Yeah. I love those three guys, Huey, Dewey, and Louie.
Oh, look at who's here. This is Casey Jr.
That's the little circus train from Walt Disney's Dumbo, along with a bunch of crazy clowns. Incidentally, Dumbo was the least expensive animated feature ever made. Less than $1 million, can you believe it? Today's prices.
That is an expensive for an animated feature film. And by the way, Dumbo takes place here in Florida.
Yeah, that's right. Matter of fact, he's 50 years old, isn't he?
50 years old, he doesn't look a day over.
Another anniversary, Joan. This is turning into the anniversary show.
Yeah, he really took off, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then there's another young performer who's off to a flying start, if you will. Blossom's Mayim Bialik, and she is at the Animation Building at Disney MGM Studios. And take it away, Mayim.
Hi, everybody. I'm discovering the most wonderful things here at the Disney MGM Studios. It's so exciting. Right behind me is the Disney Animation Building, where you can see Disney animators drawing and creating actual pieces of animation. Did you know that scenes from Roller Coaster Rabbit, The Rescuers, and Disney's latest animation masterpiece, Beauty and the Beast, were created right here? Simply incredible. And that's what everybody's saying about Beauty and the Beast. Here's a clip from the film, and then we've got a very special surprise in store for you. Scenes from the new Beauty and the Beast stage show. Take a look.
Is anyone here?
Mama, there's a girl in the castle.
Good.
A girl? She's the one. She has come to break the spell.
I don't want to have anything to do with him.
She is being so difficult.
There's something sweet.
Straighten up.
And almost kind.
Show me the smile.
But he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. And now he's dear.
You look so...
And so...
Stupid.
I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
And now, let's go to the Theater of the Stars on Hollywood Boulevard, where from the pages of the classic fairy tale, the Disney MGM Studios is proud to present Beauty and the Beast.
The girl is so peculiar, I wonder if she's feeling well.
With a dreamy, far-off look,
and her nose stuck in a book.
What a puzzle to the rest of us is
Belle. Oh, isn't this amazing? It's my favorite part, because you'll see.
You shouldn't have come to the West Wing.
And you should learn how to control your temper.
Say something nice to her.
Try to act like a gentleman.
I apologize.
Apology accepted.
There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. And now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
The beast will make off with your children. He'll come after them in the night. No one will be safe until his head is mounted on my wall. I say we kill the beast! The mist through the woods, through the darkness and the shadows. It's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer and we're there at the drawbridge of a castle, and there's something truly terrible inside. It's a beast! He's got fangs, razor sharp ones, massive paws, killer claws for the beast. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead, kill the beast!
For real, this year's biggest movie stars, Beauty and the Beast.
And what a hit they are. Look at Belle. She really is a beauty. You know, that beast is one lucky beast, Joan.
Yeah, he's crazy about her. And even though he seems fierce and mean, Belle knows that he's good inside.
And it's a terrific stage show. And yesterday I watched the beast pose with pictures with the University of California football team there. The stage show reminds me of one of the all-time great musicals you see on Broadway. But you see it right here at Disney MGM Studios.
And you can see a lot more Christmas parade magic in just a moment. We will be right back.
Hi, I'm Robbie Benson. Merry Christmas and happy 20th anniversary, Walt Disney World.
Up next, join the fun with the Disney girls, plus Goofy, Pluto, and Chip and Dale.
Check it out, man. Look who's here.
Hey!
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
I'm
I'm Chase.
I'm Damon.
I'm Tiffany.
I'm Albert.
And I'm Dee Dee.
And we're the party!
Wishing everyone out there a Merry Christmas and a happy, safe New Year.
Most definitely.
Here's a little song for the holidays.
Let's kick it.
All right, Dee Dee.
Sleigh bells ring while you're listening. In the land, snow is glistening.
Oh,
a beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
Merry Christmas!
Love.
We out.
Have a good one.
Everybody,
take care.
God bless.
That's a nice warm Christmas greeting from one of today's hottest new pop groups, The Party.
Yeah, they're called The Party, and they're on the rise with a new single called In My Dreams.
And we are back with more Christmas dreams come true from Walt Disney World in Florida.
Lots of great parade coming your way just ahead. A visit to the Euro Disney Resort outside of Paris, France.
The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Santa Claus are on their way, too.
But right now, let's get back to the Magic Kingdom as the new surprise celebration continues.
And look, two of my favorite little guys are coming down the street.
Love them, don't you, Joan?
Yes.
Chip and Dale have spent their whole careers driving Donald Duck nuts. They drove them nuts.
They're part of the Rescue Rangers team on TV, solving cases that no one else can.
That's right. Now, who's Chip and who's Dale again?
Chip has the black nose, Dale has the red nose. Dale has two teeth, Chip has one.
Joan,
you could always tell. This
I
is
go
the
to
important
you.
Stuff, you know?
You are the source of all this material here. Now we got a special treat coming up, the Caribbean Carnival. Disney's Calypso dances. You like this touch in the parade?
I really do. It's so colorful and the music is so great. And it really gives a party atmosphere.
This is the first year where I've ever seen the Calypso.
And we've got some more produce there for you. All right, we've got another incredibly big Disney star coming our way.
One is on its
Mickey
way
Mouse's
right now, Joan.
Best friend for over 60 years.
Oh, Mickey Mouse's best friend?
Pluto.
400 dog years old, it's got to be. It's Pluto. Look at him.
Almost as big as planet Pluto right now.
Look at the size of that pooch.
I wonder how many kids watching would like to take this giant canine home, huh? Hey, look at the blimp shot there.
Yeah, great blimp shot.
Now, I should say once again, Captain Jim Dexter is at the control. This is the Aerial Adventures light ship. They provide sightseeing for people, and you can see Orlando, but this morning you see this beautiful sight on Main Street. Look how big that thing is. Oh, look at the Pluto fans.
The Pluto groupies are here. Boy, they're excited, too.
Sounds like Pluto's pretty good on those steel drums today,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he does it all, doesn't he? Look at him looking down, benevolently at the crowd. He loves them, and they love him.
There's this silly guy.
Those bears are whacking out those steel guitars. Now, who are they?
Oh, look at I see the Country Bear Jamboree guys are out there. Wendell, Liver Lips, and Shaker are also there.
Ooh, look at this two-faced Justin. Would you buy a used car from that guy? That guy I would, but this guy maybe not.
He's talking out of both sides of his mouth, I can tell.
Sure is.
I think you should try your hand or your legs at this.
That's my New Year's resolution. I'll learn how to do that.
I'm sorry.
Oh, come on.
That looks hard.
Mardi Gras time here.
There's another shot. I don't know if that shot's from one of the cameras on the inflatables or up at the blimp, but boy.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
The choreography alone that goes on here in order to put this parade on is mind-boggling.
Yeah.
The costume department here making all these costumes. Mm. They literally start the day after one parade is over. They start getting ready for the next year.
Another super-sized Disney friend is on his way.
Yes, a resident jack-of-all-trades, golfer, tennis player, surfer, Olympic champ. He tries everything.
He's the greatest goof in the ball. It's Goofy.
Love Goofy. And that's a gargantuan Goofy. And up above on his nose, or even above his nose, is a Goofy cam. And you're looking at a Goofy shot, right? Down. Look at that. Straight down.
It's a little Goofy just to look down there. A little dizzy, at least. He's always dizzy, though.
You can kind of get a feel, though, how big it is.
Yep.
There's a blimp shot.
Mm-hmm.
And look at those things towering over the building. Hi, Goof. How you doing, Goof?
Bloody nose. That monkey, he can't hide from me.
He's got two great teeth, doesn't he? Ah, there's a lot to see here today, but then there's always a lot to see and do at Walt Disney World, Joan.
That's right. 3 theme parks, 2 water parks, a zoological park, an island night spot,
and 11 Disney resorts, each with its own special style, from the classic Yacht and Beach Club and Grand Floridian to the brand new Dixie Landings and Dixie Vacation Club. It's all here.
So join us now for a tour around the Walt Disney World resorts with the Disney Girls.
California.
Wishing you and your family a very Merry Christmas.
And happy 20th anniversary Walt Disney World.
Don't go away. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles are next. Plus a sneak peek at the new Euro Disney Resort in France. We'll be right back.
In South Carolina. Go Tigers! They sure look and sound great as they come around the World Showcase Lagoon in EPCOT Center. You know how they got to be so good? Practice, practice, practice.
Welcome back to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. I'm Mayim Bialik, and I'm here in France. Now, you may be wondering how I got from the Disney MGM Studios to France so quickly. Well, I'll let you in on a little secret. This is France in EPCOT Center's World Showcase. It's terrific here. You can travel all around the world, from Italy to Germany, even to China. It's really cool. Now, next year in April, folks all over Europe will get to enjoy their own Disney experience when the Euro Disney Resort opens up in France outside of Paris. In fact, everyone in Europe is so excited, they're all talking about it. So let's take a listen.
It's gonna be great. It's gonna be wonderful. If it's anything like the ones from the States, it's gonna be fantastic.
I just can't wait to go.
Ich weiß, dass Euro Disney im nächsten Jahr jetzt eröffnen wird. Ich glaube im April.
Wir möchten gerne nach Florida mal gehen, aber jetzt können wir nach Euro Disney gehen.
Ja, erstmal nach Paris.
Ho già la valigia pronta.
Mia figlia addirittura è innamorata di Topolino.
Penso che l'arrivée d'Euro Disney in Europa sia qualcosa di magnifico.
Moi, je suis très impatient de voir l'ouverture du parc, en tout cas.
I don't have kids, but I'm a kid, and it will be a great success.
Right now, let's head over to Marne-la-Vallée, site of the new Euro Disney Resort, and check out what the excitement is all about.
Après Mickey, on passe à l'antenne bientôt. Mais aussi, ah, bonjour, joyeux Noël, and welcome to Euro Disneyland. I am Sabine Marcon, the Euro Disney Ambassador, and I think you know my friends. As you can see, everyone here is busy getting ready for a big opening next April. Just 20 miles outside Paris and one-fifth the size of the city, the Euro Disney Resort will be the biggest entertainment destination in Europe. Sleeping Beauty Castle, le Château de la Belle au Bois Dormant, will be the centerpiece of Euro Disneyland, Europe's first ever Disney theme park. We're not open yet, but since you're here, come on along and we'll give you a sneak preview. Welcome to the Casbah! Well, this is actually the Adventureland Bazaar, where the spirit of the 1001 Arabian Nights come alive. Like Disneyland and Walt Disney World, Euro Disneyland will have many lands to explore. But that's where the similarity ends. Like Discoveryland, created especially for Euro Disneyland. A look at the future by great European visionaries such as Jules Verne, H.G. Wells, and Leonardo da Vinci. To Europeans, America's early Wild West days are a fascinating period of time. The Far West, cowboys, riverboats, we'll get to see it all right here in Frontierland. And that's only the beginning. For Europeans, the Euro Disney Resort will be like visiting America, with 6 hotels offering different tastes of America, from New England to New York to the rustic beauty of the national parks and the western frontier. And there is also Festival Disney, where you can be part of a Wild West show. This year, people from all over Europe will be coming to enjoy all the magic of the Euro Disney Resort.
And no matter what language they speak, it all translates to a lot of fun. We still have a lot of work to get ready for opening day on April 12th. And I guess we'd better get back to work. So for now,
a bientôt, goodbye, au revoir, see you soon, Merry Christmas to you all!
And a thanks to Sabine Marcon. That was her first time ever on camera. A terrific tour. You know, you walk through a place like this here in Florida, yep, and you can take it for granted until you see all the work that goes into
incredible
building something like
what
this.
What a job they have done. You know that resort is now half the size of Paris, France already?
Unbelievable. We've got to get ourselves an invitation to that one. There's a lot of things going on here, though, and let's go back now for some parade magic down at the Disney MGM Studios. Coming down Hollywood Boulevard, the newest character here.
You know who that is? That's Darkwing Duck, the terror that flaps in the night.
And he's got his sidekick there, Launchpad McQuack.
Yeah, and they're at Mickey's Starland in the Magic Kingdom. Darkwing and Launchpad, all of them in a brand new live stage show.
Hey, you never know what celebrities will stop by the Disney MGM Studios. Here comes one that's got four wheels.
What a popular guy he is. Herbie the Love Bug, star of 4 big screen Disney comedy vehicles. Get that, Joan?
I caught that, yes.
And his own TV miniseries. You get that, Joan?
Yes. He hasn't seemed to want the elves, though, there to tinker with him. He says, get away, I'll bite you.
Sort of like when I try to give my cat a bath. A million laughs.
This one always brings a lot of laughs as he comes down the street. Hey,
look who's here, Joan.
I love these
guys. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
And you can meet the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles every day at the Disney MGM Studios. Totally radical dudes, you know what I mean?
Boy, are they popular.
Watch this performance because it's a really good one. Mm-hmm. You better watch out, dude. I'm talking about the music. You better not shout. Don't pout, freak out. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Yeah.
Well, thanks, dudes, for that totally awesome performance.
They're incredible, aren't they? You know, I can relate to them, too, because my favorite color is green, and I love pizza.
All right.
I am one of them.
Can you dance like them, though?
No.
We've got lots more fun coming your way, so don't go away. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Betty White from the Golden Girls. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Lots more Christmas surprises coming your way, including a very special appearance by Mickey Mouse.
Welcome back, everyone, to all the fun and magic of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade live from Florida.
Beautiful shot of the Polynesian Hotel.
Yeah.
Really having a terrific time here, Joan. There's so much to see. Coming up, we'll take you on a journey through 20 years of magical Walt Disney World memories.
And the one and only Santa Claus is
You're kidding.
Its way to Main Street, USA, of course. But right now, let's see some more of the surprise celebration parade live from the Magic Kingdom. Let's go down to the street. All right. Coming down Main Street, the Royal Guard heralding that royalty is on its way. What's
mm-hmm.
that be?
Well, the ladies in waiting, yes, doing what they do best. They're waiting.
They look like pink hippos to me, Reed. This part of the surprise celebration parade has its roots in Europe, in a Venetian carnival, and you're going to see lots more Venetian costumes coming up here.
Yeah.
More of your favorite stilt dancers there.
The equestrian stilt dance is coming out in just a second. They've got those horse faces. I mean, how many of these guys have to learn this?
Gosh,
it's sensational.
As much fun here as I am. Oh boy, what a swell time!
Think you could do that?
I don't know. It took me a long time to master that. I know it took them a month to learn to still dance. Still walking is one thing, but dancing is something else.
Well, you've got the face for it. I'm sorry.
Well, Joan Lunden turning vicious in the last half hour of the Very Merry Parade.
I couldn't catch it. I've been waiting for an hour and a half to do that one.
The rebel of dancers are here.
Doing going on around
and they're
going
to rebel.
So come on and celebrate with us.
Okay. I feel in my heart that we're getting close to introducing another very big Disney star.
You think so, Ruth?
I feel it coming for me.
You mean like a really big cheese?
Yeah, I mean like the biggest cheese of them all. The most recognized star in the whole world.
You think
Maybe
so?
Maybe the whole galaxy.
Huh.
Nobody else can top this guy, and I know people wait for him every year. But he really is the king of all he surveys here.
The biggest star
He's
of all?
He's the king.
Well, that can't be anyone other than...
Yes, it is. Look, it's Mickey Mouse.
Today, though, he's King Mickey.
All dressed up in his Venetian finery. You know, Joan, Mickey's outfit came from a deck of playing cards. Did you know that?
Yeah. No.
The creator of the parade saw his daughter playing with a deck of Disney playing cards one day.
And Mickey was the king?
That's right. The Disney costume artist designed Mickey's outfit exactly the way they saw it on the Disney cards.
Did you see those people in the audience? They've got crowns on. I mean, people do that every time.
Sure.
Groupie, Mickey groupies.
Did you think that was a fascinating story or not, the one I just
Absolutely.
Told?
Absolutely.
It was a true story. Maybe not so fascinating, but true.
You know, Mickey was the first animated character who could talk.
Is that right?
Yes, they met Mickey, audiences met Mickey and Minnie in Steamboat Willie in 1928.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that shot.
Looks enormous, doesn't he?
And there's the real guy himself. He's got his Venetian finery on, too.
You know, I'm so used to seeing him in the other costume that it almost doesn't look like the same Mickey Mouse, but it is.
But it's fun to see them dressed up
yeah.
in their costumes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, folks, I hope you liked our carnival.
This is one of the most exciting moments for all the kids coming down Main Street. But we've got lots more coming your way, so we'll be back in just a moment.
Hi, we're Don and Gloria Pontius.
From Waterford, Connecticut.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
And happy 20th birthday, Walt Disney World. Merry Christmas.
Next up, America's favorite Stone Age heroes, dinosaurs, when the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
Welcome back, everyone, to the merriest Very Merry Christmas Parade there ever was.
You know who's coming now, don't you? Santa Claus coming to town very soon. You got to be patient. He's coming along with loads of living Christmas trees, snowmen, and yes, reindeer.
That's just around the corner, but right now we've got a very special treat for everyone watching. So far we've seen the Euro Disney Resort in France, Disneyland out in California. Obviously we're seeing Walt Disney World right here in Florida. Now let's go halfway around the world to say ni hao. That's hello in Japanese to our friends in Tokyo Disneyland.
Ni hao.
Look outside Tokyo in Japan, Tokyo Disneyland. This is just outside Tokyo, and since its opening in 1983, it has welcomed over 10 million visitors. Let's join them right now for a special Christmas celebration.
Christmas tree, 歌いながら さあみんなで Christmas 楽しい Christmas 素敵なプレゼント いつもと違った気分さ Christmas 夢見た Christmas 寒さなど忘れて楽しく遊ぼうさ心に灯そうよキャンドルほのぼのと作ろうケーキ靴下にキャンディー楽しくやろう Ring a bell, Christmas carol Lights and all candle All your present Christmas tree has a happy more Christmas 楽しい Christmas 見に行けよ Christmas song
That was great. Now we're back at Disney MGM Studios in Orlando, Florida for some prehistorical Christmas fun. The cast of the hit show Dinosaur.
Yes, there's Fran on the right, her son Robbie, daughter Charlene, along with Earl Sinclair, the head of the unique TV Sinclair family.
Yes, indeed, very unique. And don't let's forget Grandma Ethel.
That's Earl's mother-in-law,
she's
right?
Up there too.
You can see all the stars of Dinosaurs in person right here at the Disney MGM Studios.
Mm-hmm. It's quite a
I
hit,
love this
it?
Family. It's a huge hit, and it's really very funny, very well written.
People couldn't believe it when they first saw it, but it's turning into a long-standing hit. Oh, here they are. Now, these dancing girls must be the original Rockettes.
Rockettes. I get it, Reg. I get it.
I hope so.
They're performing with the UGG band. They're kind of the UGG dancers, too, right?
And they're terrific.
Let's watch.
An extraordinary sight, so symbolic of the Christmas season, the Toyland Soldiers making their Disney MGM Studios theme park debut.
Whether they're coming down Main Street or down Hollywood Boulevard, they are a magnificent sight. I know they're your favorites, they're mine too.
I love them.
They're of course also Disney movie stars, I should say.
From Babes in Toyland, right. As a matter of fact, which incidentally was the first live action musical Walt Disney ever made.
Now that came out actually at Christmas time in 1961, so it's 30 years old this month.
Another anniversary,
hey.
I love people like you
keep
who keep track of everybody's anniversary. They also appeared in Mary Poppins. Remember the spoonful of sugar nursery scene?
I can't tell you how many times I've seen that movie at my house.
I bet you have.
Let's listen to them right now.
Joan, why is that popping there?
Thank you.
they great?
They were. Welcome back now live to the grand finale of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Stay where you are. Santa's on his way with the grand finale to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Ah, the Grand Floridian Hotel, one of the greatest hotels in America. I love it there.
Welcome back, everyone, live to the grand finale of Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. How do you like co-hosting? It's my first. I haven't had a chance to ask you yet.
I think it's terrific. I mean, has it always been like this, sitting here nice with air conditioning and all this help here?
You don't miss getting to flirt with Cinderella and Snow White down there on the street?
It was a lot of fun down there on the street, and I miss my fans down there. Went down and said hello to them.
We've had a lot of anniversaries today, and Reese doesn't want me to mention it, but he's also celebrating an anniversary, 30 years in show business.
She can't stop with the anniversaries.
Yeah, well, I mean, you got to give credit where credit is due, right? All right, Joan, we've got a great parade going on down on the street, so let's go back down right now to Main Street for the finale of our surprise celebration for the 20th anniversary here of Walt Disney World.
Said it again. I never miss a Disney parade with Regis.
With Regis, yes. There you go.
This guy's looking for me down there. He wants to be with me.
It is a tradition, though, with so many people who come here every single year. They come in at 7 o'clock in the morning and line these streets. And this, of course, is the Christmas finale coming down Main Street.
This is the Candy House and Mrs. Claus. Huh?
And the candy canes and all the little elves. Well, you know, behind every good man there is a good woman, don't you think, Reed?
Oh, sure, and boy.
So we can't forget Mrs. Claus.
And she's been with him for all of these years, all of these eves, sending him off like that on the sleigh, packing him up real good.
He has to go all the way around the world. I hope she takes good care of the reindeer. There you go. There she is. There's right there.
Yeah. And you know that gingerbread house was once owned by a wicked witch?
Get out of here.
Yeah, she was the worst. But then Hansel and Gretel came along, and they got rid of the witch, and then they called their realtor and sold the house to Mr. and Mrs. Claus, who now use it as a summer home.
Is any of this true?
Absolutely not, but it sounds great. It's a great story. I love saying it.
Oh, thank you for sharing that with us. There she is, Mrs. Claus.
Hi, Mrs. Claus. You know, she looks just like him.
Well, they say after you live with someone for a while, you start to look like them.
Those ruddy red cheeks.
Edible home there.
A lot of characters behind that house, too.
A whole cast of characters. Oh, there's Peter Pan and Wendy. Wendy Darling, who flew with Peter Pan and her brothers to Neverland.
Mary Poppins and Bert.
That's right. She's the magical nanny, right? We'd all like one of those. Not only can she fly through the air, she can just wave that little hand of hers and the whole room is clean.
Little John and Friar Tuck.
The good Friar Tuck, a kind-hearted soul, a friend to all the poor people of Nottingham.
Winnie the Pooh and Tigger 2.
And Tigger 2, and Eeyore's down there. Hi, Eeyore.
Winnie's waving to everybody there. Tigger!
And there's Tigger. He's such a zany little
Tigger's
guy.
Tigger's romping.
Yes, he romps. I've always loved Winnie the Pooh, too.
Yeah, great collection of characters.
That was a 1973 Disney classic, Robin Hood. You saw Friar Tuck and all of them.
Yep. All together out there.
Well, here come all the Christmas trees.
They're in full bloom, aren't they?
But they're living Christmas trees, Reach. They dance, they go, and they see all the little children. There's the gingerbread men.
Another popular holiday tradition, that gingerbread man. I love when those trees start dancing, actually. Oh, here come the gingerbread men.
Fresh out of the pan, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that tradition was started by Queen Elizabeth I. She threw a big, big surprise party for her court, and then she gave each of the lords and ladies a giant gingerbread man.
Sounds like a great door prize to me.
Yes.
Actually, I always think of the gingerbread man as a children's story. I used to read it to my little girls when they were growing up. Snowmen everywhere.
And they're dancing with the kids of the kingdom.
You actually see all of these performing all over the park in live musical shows.
A lot of talent down here.
See way back there, Joan, those are the reindeer.
For the time of Christmas is here. Look around.
have to give a big thanks to these reindeer. I mean, these reindeers are the ones that take Santa all over the world. They do flew it everywhere last
And they
night.
Do it every year, don't they? And they never look the least bit tired. That's what I like about them. They're fresh reindeer.
They look very happy. They must love to fly.
And it shows.
They just flew in, and boy, are their arms tired.
Come on. It's Henny Lemon. There they are, right in step, too.
Well, if those are the reindeer, then we probably should be getting ready for another really, really, really big surprise.
Yeah, we're getting
right?
close. It's got to be
a
the man
guy
himself.
In a
yeah.
red suit. There's the guy himself, Santa, with his giant inflatable Santa.
Coming right down Main Street, USA.
Now, there's also a camera up on top of Santa, and he's looking down right now, and you're seeing Santa. Look at him.
Santa, how are you?
He looks pretty good for a guy who's worked so hard all night, don't
mm-hmm,
you think?
Very fresh.
Did he give you everything that you asked for?
Oh, sure. Absolutely.
Well, good.
Look at the size of that Santa Claus. I mean, what chimney is going to accommodate him? I wonder how many chimneys he's going to fit in.
I don't know. I don't think that there's a child down there that can keep smiling though when Santa goes down the street, or maybe not even an adult too.
Yeah, you gotta go along with that. They love him. You know, you and I meet a lot of celebrities in our line of work, but I think you'll have to agree there's nobody quite like Santa Claus. He's the one you wait for all year long.
Well, Reed, between the two different parades this year, look at that. Oh, that's the blimp shot there.
Blimp shots.
That would knock them around a little bit up there. But I'll tell you, these two parades this year, I think this has been the most spectacular Walt Disney World parade ever.
I've loved it, and I love being here with you, too, John. It's been great.
It's been great. And with that, we leave you, and we hope everyone has enjoyed the parade today.
Well, thank you, Joan. I loved every minute of it. And from Joy and our family, Merry Christmas, everybody.
Happy holidays, and thank you, everyone, for watching.
And from my family, Michael, Jamie, Lindsay, and Sarah, and from the entire Walt Disney World family, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas!
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Tylenol and all the products that carry the Tylenol name. Caring isn't just what we do, it's who we are. Kissimmee, St. Cloud, Florida, the vacation destination in the middle of Central Florida's best attractions. Location is our biggest attraction. And Kellogg's, proud sponsor of our 1992 Olympic team, helping make Olympic dreams come true. Air transportation for the talent and crew provided by Delta Airlines, the official airline of Walt Disney World. Deluxe accommodations provided by the Walt Disney World Dolphin, located in the heart of the EPCOT Resort area, where every minute is magic. Disney World family to yours. This is Dick Tufeld wishing you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.